Good evening from the Kingdom of Balance. This is Princess of Balance here with day 176 of going through the bundle for racial justice and equality. I do this stream every Monday and Wednesday to showcase three games from this bundle. Today we will be looking at games number 526 to 528. First up we have Akura by Jason Newman. And after that, it's Belong by A Flutter Studios. I think it's a visual novel. The first one was a puzzle open world adventure of some sort. The last one is a ZX Spectrum game called Jumpin' Jupiter. This is the Jumpin' Jupiter Prelude, and it's by Quantum Sheep. There's another Jumpin' Jupiter that's more full, and I think it's harder somehow. This is the prelude, we'll be showcasing the prelude today. So that's our lineup for today. I'm excited to explore all of them. I haven't played them before, as usual. I never play them, generally don't play most of these games beforehand. So I just explored them on stream. I also ordered some tea, some bubble tea, and I'm looking forward to it. So I might have to pause to go get it, but it'll be fine. It'll be a short time. Okay, so let's go into our first game. Game number 526. Akura. I love the colors. Colors are awesome. Okay. So it's a top-down bird's eye view puzzle game. Looks like a lot like Zelda. But I think it's got a lot of box pushing involved. Which is an old mechanic. It's an old game style. So I believe it'll have all the challenges of those that style. Like, it's one of the first genres I played actually years ago. Where you can only like push the boxes around, you can't pull them. So you'd have situations where you'd get stuck in corners and you could like lose the box in a corner. I bet the games nowadays are gonna compensate for that in some ways, but it's one of my earliest exposure to getting stuck in video games. Long time ago. Right, so the game description says, explore ancient puzzle filled islands, meet strange new friends, and unlock epic secrets in an atmospheric world with retro aesthetic. Experience a creative new take on a classic puzzle genre in the open world puzzle adventure Akura. Awesome. If you like my games, please consider joining our Discord. Okay, so Jason has a Discord. You can all join. You can get it at the link. Actually, speaking of links. Here's the link to the game. To the dev profile, rather. You can get it at gojira.itch.io. Nice name. Alright. So they have their Discord, their email, their Twitter, and there's a note for Mac users. And it's, wow, it's free. Wow, the game is free. Well, at least the first chapter is free. If you go try it out. Or, you know, give them money, that's also fine. It looks really good, in my opinion. Like, the color balance is really good. Which is a very important thing for, well, most art, but pixel art in particular. Yeah, let's go check this out. Here we go. Look at the colors. So pretty. It's got all my colors, except for the orange and the yellow. Well... yeah. Except for the orange and yellow, everything else is our colors, our combined colors. Thank you, Shelly. Thanks for the host. Forgot to activate my controller. Alright, so we have movement. Then we have an undo. Wow. An undo is gonna be super useful in a puzzle game. We have the reset. We have pause and start. Okay, it's very, very straightforward. Just movement, I guess. Game by Jason Newman. I don't know why we have a box in the corner. It might be related to the game. That's interesting. It's following the same aesthetics as the game, so it must be part of the game. Oh, three slave slots. Just like all Nintendo games. This interface is exactly like a Nintendo. Like the, I wouldn't say N64, but like the other ones. Well, maybe in N64 as well, you had this. I have streamer mode on. I don't know what that means. I don't know what streamer mode will do, but we'll go with that. See, the copy file, erase file, those options, I've seen that only in Nintendo. In this format, in like, listed like this. Alright, so we're gonna go with the first one. Oh, we have to enter a name. I generally pick Balance as the name because I want all of our headmates to play the game. But it's like, when I want my own game, I name it Lily, but when I want to share a save with everybody, that's when I use Balance as the profile name. Not that you asked, I just wanted to mention it because we're doing it. I really love the interfaces at the top, the box and the stuff. Yay! Love this Zelda look. It's such an old Zelda look. It's the Nintendo 1. Like, not Nintendo 1. Original Nintendo Zelda look. I just tested out the undo button. See, if you push it and then you press that, it undoes the last action. That's cool. There's a key here. Can't seem to push it. Can't push. Okay, I like the animation versus this training to push. I bet eventually you're gonna get enough strength to push some of these other ones. Ooh, that's such a neat idea. That, if that's how they did it. The arrow show which direction to push. I think this is the thing that unlocks that. Yeah. You ring a bell and that thing disappears. Now we got a key. Oh, the inventory is at the top. All those palm leaves are so awesome. Like the ones blowing in the wind. I didn't go in the water. Oh my god. I can, but I die in the water. Look at that. Okay, so I think this is the thing? Yeah. Oh. Ah. Ah, interesting. It's like... It looked like, you know, opening a big gate, but through explosions. Mm-hmm. So, four... I need four. Okay, that's fine. Is that an enemy? Oh. It's a pit. It's a pit. Okay. There we go. Cool. They'll open that. And I need a green key to go through this. Okay. Got it. Oh, this is really nice. Like, such simple mechanics, but there's complexity to it. What is this? Oh, you can only pass once. There are hidden traps. Okay, so I need a box for this to go across, and then there's a blue thing over there, but first I need to ring the red thing. Yeah. What are these things? Oh, it's open world, right? I got the green key there. Oh, I need three green keys to unlock that star. Let me just see what we can do on this side first. It's a one way. Okay. Oh. Oh my god. So cool. This is an open world puzzles are awesome. Okay, I'm really excited for this game. Okay. I think the first thing is this side. There we go. Now the question is, how do we do the bottom one? Oops. There we go. Not this way, here. It's good that you don't go out with the box when you push it. You like push it.
Punch it.
Yeah, you're punching it basically. Shoving it to the next thing. Okay, so that's done. Oops. I keep forgetting that about that thing. Okay, so we got one green key. We need two more to unlock the door on the top. Oh, look, it's a grass. Grass, tall grass. Okay, so that's two. I saw oh, it resets the puzzle when you leave the room. That's interesting. Is this a can I stand on this and not have it explode right away? Okay. Interesting. Okay, so we can reset the room. Just wanted to see what that does. So yeah, if you want to create a way back, then that's... And then... This way? Yeah. Well, I guess I could have just created a way back using this box going backwards. I think Okay, I have a thought. Let's do this. I got the... No, I didn't. Then why do I have only two keys?
Because you do access.
Ah. Right. It's fine. Okay, so... What I want to do now is... Okay. Oops. I reset the whole room instead. Okay, never mind. We'll do it this. Okay, got that. Now we go back. Now, I wanna push this. Oh, wait. Yeah. I wanna push it off. That's why what I've been wanting to do. There we go. So now I can do this part. I don't know, it's a tree trunk? Okay. We'll need one of those. And we need this. Our tea is on. No, still some time left on that. 10 minutes or so. Okay. So, what's the next part? I could do the red thing by going on the. Yeah, I unlock more. Okay. So, the red thing first. Now then we do the blue thing. Okay. I can only get one key at a time, it seems. Let's get the closest one first. What if I just undo now? Yeah, that's it. Okay. Undoing is an actual mechanic. That's funny. Okay, now we have 4. Yay. Now we're back here. Okay, so we have 4 keys. So we could open that, possibly open that, but we have to be on the other side to do it. Because we can't push it from this side. Interesting. So, well, at least we got all 4 keys from this side. We can't walk through the trees, we can go through grass, but that's about it. We need to come from the top, it seems, somehow. So it's a Metroidvania thing, we'll have to come back. Alright. So the green one can be used to go through here. Still have 3, so that's good. Oh, there's a 3 door over there. Hey, new mechanics, there's these purple switches here. What do they do, indeed? Oh, they swap the blocks. Oh, that's cool. So if I can put a box on it and it will keep it active. Interesting. Let's do that. There we go. Then I can ring that. And then push the box off. And I can ring this. I bet in the future there would be some mechanics where you're not supposed to ring the bell right away. You have to wait because you have to push something and to like use it as a barrier or something. In the future, I'm sure we'll get those. I would love to make games like this. Hey, he's sleeping because I waited too long. We did those two. Well, we'll have to go through here at some point. And then there's the golden one. The golden one's way over there. Okay, well, let's go through here first. Or try to, at least. Oh, I'll have to slide a box in. Yeah, so I have to go around. Okay, so I can just go like this. Oop, don't fall into the water. Here we go. I can also open this door. Well, let's do this first. Oh, it can go through, right. Okay. Cool. Can't go through that spike, but it can go through. That's good. Then we get this. That's a fork. Okay. So now we can just... Oh, there's a down here. All right. Interesting. The portal. I don't know what the portals do yet. Interesting. Huh. Well, then you can drop something maybe from the top. Yeah. So. Oh, we can only drop and do it again. Cool. Now, what was the point of doing that? I can push the box into the portal. Oh my god. Let's try that. Oh my god, that's so cool. Oh yeah. There we go. These are such good puzzles. These are brilliant mechanics. We got 5 keys. Okay, so these are open. I can just go through instead. Yeah. Nothing else to do here, right? Yeah, so just open this. I got 2 keys left. Hey, what is this? A star? Oh, is that star that we saw behind that, the sleeping star behind that other door? Hey, Mustasia! Hi. So I'm also snacking at the same time. So there would be gaps in my... in what I say. Where's our tea? It's coming. 4 minutes left. 2 minutes left. Thank you. That looked cool. So happy to have a star. Oh, these stars are cumulative. You see that? So there will be blocks that has like 2 or 3 stars. So you'd have to have 2 or 3 stars in total. That's kind of cool. It's a turtle! It's a turtle! A giant turtle. Oh my god, you get to explore like that? That's so cool! Isn't this amazing? This is like one of the best things I've seen. What? What? This is so cool. And this is a 3-star path. This is a 100-star path. Oh, I love. Okay, these kind of like open world games, I'm really, really big fan of. I love this. This is so cool. There's one here. There's one here. And it's indicated by that little wave thing. I love how the clouds, there's like the reveal cloud and then there's the regular clouds. It's so cute, like that it becomes transparent, but you can still see the shadow. Oh, this is beautiful. Such good work. I'm just so, so impressed with this little shrine or something here. And a green key. Oh, that's a 7-star. Okay. We'll have to come back when we have a 7-star, but we can go through here. Huh. It's a different shade of green or something? Huh. It's very subtle. Okay, now we're starting to have other color keys. Cool. Okay. Oh, I better check on the tea. I'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, I'm back. We got some good tea here. All right. Okay, well, I see some stairs over here. Is this a... it's a back. Okay. And I don't have the key for that thing. Ooh. What's this? You can pass on it once before it crystallizes. So it is like a trap, or more like a block. Okay. Alright, so I need to do that. Huh. Okay. Okay. Or no. No, we can't do that.
No, I think
yeah, there we go. Now we can get out from the bottom. There. We got something new! We got a gem of some sort. And what's this? Oh, that's so cool. I wonder if I can take the block to the next screen. Is that allowed? No, I can't. Okay. Okay, well, it's got reset anyway. Spiral. I'm just doing this because it's fun. There should have been an achievement for this, for doing this. What kind of tea? I ordered some bubble tea. It's got the it's got a brown sugar pearled bubble tea. It's a black tea that has some brown sugar pearls in it. They made it really strong this time. Okay, so we got one key that we can open this with. And that can be pushed back. Are we going up? I think we're going up. Maybe? Yeah, I think we're going up. I'm just trying things at this point. We can bring it back again after. But also... Yes, now we can do this, yes. There we go. You know, one thing I couldn't remember is if you put a block on top of an unactivated trap, if it would fall through. And clearly it does. Yay! Okay. At that, so now the other one. Oh, there's an up, there's a down too. Let's see what's here. There's this puzzle, and then there's this puzzle. I don't have the thing for it yet. This looks like a robot. Do you see that? These two are eyes. These two are eyes, and this is the body. And these are the legs. That's cute. Okay. I know. We'll have to create a way back. Okay, I think we have to. No, we can't go from the top. Oh. Okay. We'll have to put it in first. In the middle. I think. I don't know how that would work either. We'll need both boxes on the left. Ring that first before we can get to that. Interesting. Can this fall in the hole? It does, but it doesn't cover it. Okay. Symmetry. Hold on. Hold on a second. You can't push two boxes at once. Okay, so this has to go for sure. Now we need to reset it using the thing somehow. Tell me first. Here. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah, good point. Good point. That actually makes more sense. Yeah, because that way is actually available now. Yeah, shouldn't have done that. Okay. Might cause problems later, but we'll see. Okay, so we got this. We got that. Now we can use the blue one now because that thing is available. Okay, cool. Okay, now we can go back. There we go. So tricky and so cool. Okay, so we got four of these. Don't know what they're for yet. Okay, so we got the red one before. We need this one, but we can only get it from the other side. So let's go up instead. Okay, so there's a star over there. And the thing is over there. It's past the blue one. Whoa. Are we... Oh, this guy needs six. Cool. I got four. I need two more. Let's see what this does. I think this is going to take me to the other... Oh, no. Okay, no. Not exactly, but... Okay, well, at least we got another key. Okay. There's no way to drop down. Don't have that yet. What's this? Got like every color here. Five colors here. Hey, what's this? Oh, it makes music. No? Might need a device or something. There's also this side I can activate. I have enough keys for it. Oh! You just got something, like music. We have six of them that we need to collect. I guess those are hidden musical notes. I love the design of these. Look at the grass patterns and little bits of breeze. This is so cool. Love the symmetry. I want to check out the stuff on the right first. Ah, we got another star. We got two stars now. We did down because this was down and then side is blocked. Or we could go to the underground. This has no... I guess... I don't see any way to do this one yet. Oh, yeah, I can do this one. Sort of. then I can't come back. Oh, it's a permanent key. Oh, so I can unlock it, all of them. Oh, that's cool. Alright, so we just need one more. So I can go back and unlock all the golden keys now. I think there are some others that I saw. This one too. Okay, that unlocks a whole lot of places now. There's a person. They ran away. That's what I thought would happen. One of those things. It'll push it on the on a side that I can't access after. Although I can maybe do this one with that. Okay, I see. Hold on. It's this way. This one here. And then this one here. And then push it. Which way? Doesn't seem. We use the portal, it would. Oh. Okay. I got it. I think so. First one I have to do is. Yeah. Oh, hold on, hold on, hold on. I'm gonna get the green key first. Or try to at least. Oh, go around, get the green key first. Okay, now we reset, and now we do it that way. This one. Yeah, yeah, we're gonna do that. Yeah, and then the other one can come. Okay. This goes here. And then push it to the right. Yeah, okay. And that would unlock this. Okay. Let's do that first. Okay, so this will then unlock that. Now I'm trapped on this side. And we got this. Do that. Oops. I always miss those ones. I don't want to go on the eagle. Is it my trigger something? Secret music notes. Okay, I only have one green key. Okay, so now we're back here. We can do something different with the blocks to get to that thing. Okay, well, there's many ways to go about it. I want to experiment and explore. Thing, but the portal thing only goes one way. Well, I can use this thing in the middle. Yeah, and use it to block the other passageway here. Yeah. There we go. Then this can lead me to that gem. I like that they sparkle when you're able to pick it up. I think I got everything that is to that I can pick up here. I like the progression markers. Like the stars indicate where your progress is, like that this is something that's gonna unlock once you get 5 stars. But they don't tell you how to get 5 stars, like you could get it in any order. That's cool. We did everything here. Now the only thing left is the oh right, this thing. What do I need for it? I feel like an ability or something is missing. Two notes now. Okay, so I need all the notes. Let's check out the cave. More puzzles. Oh, is this a cave that I have to come from various directions and to different parts? That seems like it. Cool. There was another cave here. Okay, I think I'm missing some abilities or something. So far, we haven't gotten stuck in any corner.
Wait.
I've never played open world box puzzles before. That's what happened. There's four. Oh, what? Oh, now we're in the next layer. Okay, so we have one out of next. So I need like, yeah, like 11 of them or something. What kind of block did he destroy? Is it like a stone? Oh, okay, hold on. Okay, so he jumps over hits as well. Up, let's do up. It's a remote push. Here we go. Got the green. Maybe these creatures are in other stages as well now. Ah, there they are. So now we can use them to break boxes and stuff too. Okay, that makes more sense now. And we can also use the boxes as a marker for where they stop. Right? I think that's...
Maybe,
let's try this. No, it doesn't go. Okay. Hmm. Okay, what can I do from here? Nothing. Okay. Ah, there we go. It's a remote push. Okay. So here... right, maybe. Let's try that. Hmm, cool. Interesting idea. Let's try that. Huh. And then this way. Ah, cool. This has so much layers to it now. Shell Smiley, and I've been craving that taro milk slush. Yeah, that's where we got the bubble tea from. So now that this is broken, this is permanent, right? There we go. Why is one of the flutes... Do you see, like, at the top where the musical notes are? One of them is flashing. Does that mean it's here somewhere? Huh. I only found two.
There, it's there.
Okay, there we go. That's such a cool indicator that it's here in this screen. There we go. Okay. Got that.
Now you need to talk.
Yeah, I need to.
Okay.
We could use one of them, yeah. Okay, no, I have an idea. Oh, I can't push this. Damn. Well, now that the... Oh, the blue is still not done. Huh. I had an idea. But it's not gonna work right now. Okay, so we can go the other way, too. To get this one out. I could put something to block it. I think the golem can stand at the on the purple thing. Yeah. But we'll have to unlock these. Well, you know,
they jump over holes,
so we don't need to cover the block, the holes themselves.
But you need second.
Okay, so now we could use this after, but we'll need blocks to do them. Okay, so they're ready now.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I'm wondering if there's another option. To have one block free. I guess we don't need it. No, we don't need it.
Can
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it worked. Okay, so I got 4 stars now. No, this part is done. I don't think there was any. Oh, there's some here. Oh, all the yellow rocks became golems. That's what happened. So at some point, these can become golems too, maybe. It could happen, you never know. Okay, so it... Oops. I guess that'll work. I know. Well, actually...
Okay. Push a second.
Oh, right, yes. That'll work. No, then I can't push it left again. So that's not it. Okay, it does have all the box traps.
No! No, I'm up. Then toward the red block.
Oh, the red block is a stop. I forgot. Yeah.
Then up again.
And now, cascade. Now I can go get those 3 keys. Okay, we got 5. Nothing else here. Nothing on the left, I think. We need 1 more star. Okay. So... let's do the... I think there might be more down here. Not here, but... let's see what happens here. Nothing has changed here. And we still haven't... don't have this thing. We have to come from the left to get that. Nothing here. I can open this. Because I got the permanent key. Okay, cool. Ah, there's a golem here. Oh, there's a sleeping bear. There's a sleeping bear and there's the cave. This will give me the other side of it, I think. Maybe. Hey, what are these red things? Oh my god, it's an entire space here. Okay. Well, that's elaborate. Yeah, there's something different about this one. Do it differently. Well, I can pass through first, but that doesn't help. Wait. What if I do this, go around, do this, and then pass through the trap? Yeah, there we go. Here we go. Yay. Oh. This is another door with different symbols on it. What's this? Nothing? Hey, those are symbols. So I need to put blocks on them or something? Okay, these are keys. Okay, and I can't push them. Interesting. I need something for it. Mm-hmm. I think these two need to be activated somehow. These two blocks. Interesting. Okay, I can spend hours on this game easily. Oh, what? Secrets? Secrets? Okay. This game is going to take so much of my attention. Hey, what? How do we get there? Oh, hey, is that part? Remember that part? We unlocked one, but not the other two. Oh, there it is. Wonder if there's... here we go. Oh, this is fun. Oh, there you go. There you go. Yeah. That's a down. I bet it's somewhere here then. Yes. Huh. 15, wow. And there's a black crystal next to it. Whoosh. This game is fantastic. Whoever made this is so good. Oh, there we go, there we go.
No, unlock this.
Now we have a clear path. Yay. Okay. And unlock. Nice. We're like all linking together now. No. I thought that was a way, but I tried the other side. It's not. Nothing on this side. Okay. I feel like there's still more stuff here. Mm. Maybe coming from this side? Huh. Nope. I think there might be one underneath all that.
Yeah. So, go back.
Let's see. Can I come from this side? Okay. So, below. Go down and go right. No, there's no right. Nothing here. Well, there is a secret here somewhere, as shown by the green key. Okay, let's try other. Maybe there's a spot I haven't tried yet. Ah, there it is. There we go. Come on. Come on. Gotta be something here. Or that green thing. There we go. All done. Yay. Okay. That's fun. That was fun. This is done, so I can go back. It's a shortcut. All done. We did this. I saw another set of stairs going up somewhere. I'm trying to remember exactly. I think it's on the left, maybe? Yeah, there you go. Oh, there's more secrets here. Okay, cool. Let's look for them. Push against... Oh, this thing. Yeah. See, there's a sign. This has a slightly different blue to it, see? So there is a way to tell. We could have gone here before.
Nope.
Oh, there's a rock blocking me. Okay. So, oh, there's another exit here. Where does this go?
Oh, you can.
Okay. Puzzle again. Puzzle time. The only thing I can actually push right now is this thing. Okay, I can... Oh, hold on. Another star and a big bell. Now we have 5 stars. Hey, there's a musical note here somewhere. Do you see it? It's here somewhere. It's glowing on the top. Oh, there it is. Okay. I can unlock the orange one. Okay, this game is fantastic. Hey, it's here. We're back to that robot scene. We can't do these yet. This game has so much depth to it. Okay, we have golems here too. We can easily lose days and hours to this game. Both Rifna and Shell Smiley has these games. Both of them, like, has the whole bundle, so. But you can probably easily lose a whole day to this. You might enjoy it so much that you're gonna forget that you're streaming. No, I'm gonna try the stairs now. Aha! We're on the other side of this. Oh. Oh, finally. Awesome. We unlocked that. Okay. We're like linking everything together. This is awesome. And look at the inventory. So much stuff you can carry. Like, imagine all the things that fit into those. There's gaps between those, the star and the gem, because there's other stuff you can collect there. And there's probably something massive that goes in that corner, in the top right corner, where that big box is. I bet that's like one of the biggest artifacts you can find. This is so fascinating. Okay. I hope it's saved automatically, because there was a save slot that I picked. I don't want to stop because it's so much fun, but we need to see the other games. We need to see the other games. Okay, here we go. So this game is super fun. It's called Akura. It's Akura by Jason Newman. You can get it at gojira.itch.io. And this is just chapter one. It's not even like the full game, and it's still so long. And also, like, it's free right now, so you can get it for free. You don't even have to pay anything. But I always advise giving as much money as you want to the dev. You can see the map. Look, you can see the whole map.
Oh,
that's so cool. And it shows you what's in each location. Oh, and it shows you what's missing in that area. You see that? It shows you like one key, one star. This is fantastic. I'm just so impressed with this. So impressed. Oh my god. Such simple controls, but it's just so good. That's such a fantastic demo, if it's just a demo. It's not even done. There's just so much left. I am just so impressed. Okay, that was fantastic. That was called, as I said, Akura by Jason Newman. You can get it at gojira.itch.io. And it's free. You can get it for 0 or 100, whatever you want. So, that was our first game. That was a great first game. We're gonna take a break. We're gonna take a 5-minute break. And we're gonna come back with our next game. Our next game is game number 527. It's called Belong. And it's by A Flutter Studios. It's visual novel. So we'll be coming back with a visual novel. See y'all in 5 minutes. Make sure you stretch and hydrate and take care of yourselves. See you soon. Hello, I'm back. Yeah, so that last game, I enjoyed it so much. I loved it. Loved it a lot. Highly recommend it. So our next game now is called Belong. It's a visual novel, so I'll be doing a lot of reading, unless it's already voiced. This one is by A Flutter Studios, and you can get it at aflutter.itch.io. Belong. It's also free right now, so you can just download it for free. It's got very cute art. The character portraits, they're very emoji-like. That's really cool. Really cool. The story is, with luck, you secured yourself a part-time job. With time, you might get more than you bargained for. Teasing. Features. Customizable main character name, gender, and personality options. Cool. Personality options? I never saw that in a visual novel. Three romanceable paths, two males and one female. No stats buildup, okay. Over 80,500 words of content. That's more than twice NaNoWriMo. That's like 2.5 NaNoWriMo worth of words. Oh yeah, it's 50,000, not 30,000. For some reason I thought it was 30,000. So 1.5 NaNoWriMo worth of words. Characters. One question mark, question mark, question mark. This is a question mark character. Your first encounter was a sticky situation. Fortunately, it didn't stick for very long. Time to time, you find the familiar red jacket within your sights. Will you take the time to sit down and know him? Huh. Mysterious. Okay. Dylan is the second one. Really, really cool. Green eyes and white hair. That's nice, interesting combo. The Chari makeup artist rather let his work speak for himself. Will you stay by his side and hear the bubbling words he struggles with? Is it Chari or Chatty? Capriana? Smiles grace her lips, her rose-tinted glasses adorns her lovely face. You can't help but wonder what lies underneath them. Okay. What's new? That's not a character. That's like, what's new in this content? Belong's first year anniversary presents complete GUI overhaul. Point of views unlocked upon completion of respective love interest routes. Each route has 3 POVs. Total POV word count of 28,000. Unlock a special POV upon collection of all the stickers. So altogether with the POVs, it is like 2 NaNoWriMo. Cool. Alright, let's try this out. I love how nicely this scene fits my overlay. All the pinks and the purples. So pretty. Okay, so we have start and load here. We have the setup here. And that's the credits, I'm guessing. Oh, Oh, so pretty. I love the butterflies. Oh no, it's not credits. It's a sticker collection that you can get. Oh, unlock them all for a special POV. Ooh. Nice. It fits my overlay so perfectly. I'm just so happy with that. The confession booth is dimly lit and humid. You're sitting inside, feeling sweat forming on your forehead. Your hands curl on your knees and you inhale deeply. The voice behind the other side is low, yet welcoming as he says a prayer. Welcome, my child. You gulp and your lips etch into a thin line. Is this confession really necessary for a trivial matter? Not that you can just leave right now. Perhaps it's easier to confess if you pretend you're here for your friend instead. Be yourself or for a friend. Let's go with honesty. No, it doesn't feel right. Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. Go on. You recall what happened earlier and your peers had called you. Sarcastic is an insult? Okay. Alright, how about selfish? Honestly, you're just looking out for your best interests like everyone else. Remember the credit public... Remember the recent public... I don't know why I saw credit. Remember the recent public holiday? Well, we had to miss our weekly practice because of it. By we, I meant my hockey team. My best friend Vita proposed to hold a practice over the weekend, which many opposed. Why did many, including yourself, disapprove of this? Weekends are supposed to be rest days, and that was rather impromptu. How can Vita expect us to come to an agreement? Did Vita have a reason to insist on training? Well, you might want to understand Vita's insistence on the makeup practice session. It might be for the well-being of the hockey team. Both of you continue as you reflect on this counsel. At long last, the confessional is over. Go in peace unto love and serve the Lord. So pretty. Look at how nice this looks. You step out of the confession room, your heart feeling lighter. Your eyes adjust to the morning light and fall on Father. Well done, my child. I hope the session has aided you. A smile etches across your lips. Talking to your parent about this certainly helped, especially when he's both your father and father. Wow, you're the child of a priest. That's gonna go well. Although you would prefer if you had done it in a more normal way. I'm no longer a child, Father. I am a grown non-binary option. I like how they did the character creation. I'm gonna go with lady. He chuckles and closes his eyes. In my eyes, you're always my child. You're about to retort that his eyes are not even open when a familiar voice fills the cathedral. You exhale and a smile graces your lips. You turn to the voice, not that you need to see her to know who she is. Vida. Vida calls out your name. Oh wow, I have to write a name. Anyone have a suggestion? Anyone in chat have a suggestion for a name? No. I'm not gonna take Riffna's suggestions. Riffna has the weirdest suggestions. Those chandeliers are making me think of How about Chantel? Yeah, sure, why not? And hello, Father Luis. Louis. Hello, Vita. Pardon me as I tend to my mushrooms, Chantel. That works well. Chantel is the name of a mushroom, too. So it makes sense he named his daughter after a mushroom. You give a nod to your father, thankful for the privacy and encouragement. He strides off to the backyard, and your attention shifts back to your visitor. In the distance, Vita waves energetically. Your eyes adjust to her bright smile and equally bright mouth. A mouth is bright. Interesting. Interesting adjective for a mouth. Let's go, Chantel. And I see you're ready, as always. Of course, you've already changed. You're always three steps ahead. However, you weren't expecting Vita to fetch you, especially after the recent squabble. Vita, hold on and let me get my bag. Hurry, or I'll inform our team that one of our precious members has been kidnapped by the Cookie Monster. Cookie Monster, huh? Okay, that's interesting. Really? Come on, it's been years. Let that rest. Huh. Maybe she was afraid of the Cookie Monster. From that puppet show that I've never seen. Sesame Street, yeah. I've seen like random episodes, but I've never actually watched a full one. Chop chop now, Chantel. Fine, just wait here. She flops down on one of the seats and presses on an imaginary stopwatch. Your time starts now. This room is so pretty. Look at how organized it is. I want my room to be this organized. This organized. Not disorganized, this organized. The room is already a mess. You can't make it worse. I love her desk. The selection of black books and selection of colorful books. Really like that contrast there. The same thing is repeated on the right side. You spot your bag on your desk, zipped and ready to go. As you're about to grab it, you look down the window. Your father is watering the mushrooms. It's watering mushrooms. I think there's something missing here about mushrooms. He looks up, wiping his sweat with his gloves. You had stopped staring before he could notice you. Good practice. As you put on your shoes, you notice your father's worn-out coat on the coat hanger. It's been a while since he got himself new clothes. He has always been humble and kind. Never once had he complained about anything. Be it bad weather, bills, and your schooling fees, even though you're not his child by blood. Perhaps you can take up a part-time job to purchase a new coat for him. Just for a coat? You're gonna take an entire job? You sure took your time. No, you're simply early. Clicking her imaginary stopwatch, she stands up. Right, let's go. Oh, this place looks... I don't like it. It's so... Is it meant to be boring? Like, this is a very, very boring building. Or maybe I'm biased because I've seen buildings like this and I don't want to see them anymore. Silence hangs in the tense air. The smile Vita offered disappeared. Say, are you free to hang out after hockey? Something's going on. You recognize it's a chance to patch things up and you won't let the opportunity slip. At our usual place? At our usual place. Okay, I like the usual place better. I don't know if this is the usual place, but... What does it say? Uncle Mag? Muggin? Uncle Muggin? Coffee, donuts, pasta and hamburger. Coffee, donuts, pasta and hamburgers, like everything. Interesting. It sounds good though. You get breakfast, you get lunch, you get dinner. Okay. Vita offers as you flop down to your usual seat. The hockey sticks lean against the glass panel window. You close your eyes, your mind recalling the confession room. Ignoring the bustling noises of the other customers, you ponder how you should bring the topic up. Your hair. What hair? your hair is short or long? Okay, let's do long. It's getting longer? Yeah, I wasn't going to say that. She shows you the leaf she plucked out and you hum. Thanks. Suddenly you hear a commotion near the entrance. Question mark, question mark, question mark. Says, and we shall be back, my people. Right, just move on already. You're blocking the door. You turn back to Vita with a blank look. The both of you start shaking with laughter and join the merry laughter in the cafe. Well, that's a first. You nod in agreement. As that has somewhat melted your worries away, you think it's time to face the music. Hey, Vita. Sorry. Vita looks up from the menu, her jaw dropped. What? I know how to apologize, especially when I'm in the wrong. I think we're both in the wrong. Who shall kick this apology session off first? She beats her chest and sits up straight. I'll start. I was too insistent the other day. I would say firm instead. Thanks. I know it's frustrating to come to school on the weekend, but I believe we need that practice. We haven't coordinated well enough previously, and we need time to work on it. Hey, why does it matter so much? In the end, you're the captain, so we have to follow your orders. That's not how diplomacy works. You guys are not my pawns. You guys are my comrades. I want everyone to understand the remedial session is for the team's well-being. Did our coach agree? Yeah. Then can I suggest to coach to at least cater our lunch for us? We can't run on empty stomachs after all. If food is what you're after, leave it to me. Does that mean you're treating us for dinner too? Bah, did I just land into your trap again? Just kidding. The both of you continue to chat till night falls, dismissing the stares from nearby customers with hearty laughter. Why are there stares from nearby? There's no school or practice today, so you're walking around town on a lookout for a part-time job. Okay, I like this city. There's a lot of... Okay, it's not super colorful, especially the street, but there is color here. There is a lot of businesses open here. I like the cuteness of some of those. There's like cute puppies on this right side. There's no school or practice today, so you're walking around town on a lookout for a part-time job. You remember your father's worn-out coat with every step, making you even more determined to get him a new one. Vita sent you a text message wishing you all the best of luck. Oh, it's sunset now. It's pretty. However, you're out of luck. The part-time jobs you've been checking up were clashing with your school schedule. The sun is starting to set. You decide to take the bus back home instead. Since your legs are tired out, you walk towards the bus stop and you notice a flyer on one of the stores. Or should you say, a studio. Ascend Studio, looking for a part-time receptionist. If interested, please enter the lobby for a walking interview. Students are welcome. Start work immediately. As you ponder whether you should give it a try, a lady in pink glasses waves in front of your face, her profile outlined by the twilight. What are you hesitating for? You take a step back. Come in! Before you can sprout any protests, she pulls you into the drama studio. You'll love it here. Everyone is friendly and you will fit in like a glove. Hey, I haven't decided whether I'll join. Good work today, Len. See you tomorrow. A lean man stands in the hallway awkwardly. He scratches his nape before disappearing. Bye, Priya. You stand in front of the door and happen to glance on the glass name plate beside it. The words engraved on the plate read, Margaret's Office. Go ahead and knock. You drag me in against my will and now you're asking me to knock? Knock yourself out. Well, since you're already here, there's no more time to waste. Good luck. Your capricious lady skips away. Your attention shifts back to the door. You muster your courage to knock. Come in. You enter the office and your eyes fall on the jovial woman sitting on the office chair. Welcome to my office. I see our star Capriana has chosen you. Let's find out why fate has brought us together today. Hello, madam. Chantel, I'm here with regards to the opening for the receptionist role. Please, take a seat. The job scope is simple. Receiving and making calls, taking down messages and updating our contact list. Oh dear me, I forgot. Do you want coffee or tea, dear? Thank you, it's fine, really. Are you perhaps a student, Chantel? Yes, I had noticed that you were recruiting students. Yes, our schedule is flexible and accommodating. Why don't you take a look? You take a look at the schedules Margaret shows you. Your face brightens up at the suitable dates and time slots. So dear, is it what you wanted? Yes, it seems too perfect, if I have to be honest. Fate works in mysterious ways. If you're sure, please sign this contract form. You can start working tomorrow. Your eyes fall onto her scarf. It reminds you of an air stewardess. Wow. Yeah, that scarf is interesting. It's almost like an ascot. Is there any uniform? Wear what represents you best, dear. It's rather eye-catching, isn't it? I meant no disrespect. Here in Ascend Studios, we aim to take flight and rise above the sky, soar your opportunities. This is what my scarf represents. Will you soar with us, Chantel? And you did it. You secured yourself a part-time job, short and sweet. Thank you. Stay on the ground and soar? On your grounds or soar? Sure, sores sounds fine. The place is nearby your school and home. Moreover, it emits a healthy working environment. See no reason to disagree. You sign the contract and nod at her question. Thank you for the opportunity. Why, hello there. Good work on reaching this point. I hope you've enjoyed yourself so far. What, you have a question for me? Who are you? Why are you here? I know why you are here. I think we're at the end of chapter one or something. Who are you? Who am I? How unfortunate that your ears have not heard of me yet. But time will tell. Patience, Chantel. Anyway, I'm here to brief you to select your protagonist wisely. What, am I playing an RPG action game? Maybe I should write a play about that. Oh, but this isn't about me. There is no fighting involved. Is that a sigh of relief or disappointment that I hear? Regardless, the story that is about to unfold would be as engaging as a flight. I hope it's up to your expectations. No, I hope it exceeds your expectations. If it doesn't, then we'll keep polishing your talents. Giving up isn't in our dictionary. Bell on G? These set of letters correspond to certain characters. You have seen them before, no matter how briefly. Oh no, I'm not going to introduce the characters to you. Where's the fun in that? Explore on your own. Exploring on your own is more enjoyable. What's your set of letters? Oh dear, fallen for my charms? Thank you, but I cannot reciprocate your wonderful romantic feelings towards me. I hope you understand. You muttered something too quickly, but you decide to let it rest. Well, you're equipped with the right knowledge now. My job here is done. I had fun chatting with you. May we meet again, Chantel. Select your route. Wow. Okay. That's interesting. Bell, Ong, or G? Your route. The path in the story. Let's go with the second one. Dylan's route. And the first one is Capriana's route. And the last one is question mark's route. Interesting. I don't know. Let's go with the first one. Rolls. The noon sun rays stream through the clouds, casting lively shadows throughout the beautiful park. I love the park. The park is fantastic. Laughter and the ringing of bicycle bells fill up the park. The brisk wind blows your hair on your face and you reach up to tuck it behind your ears. Pace yourself through the picnicking families and cyclists, focusing on reaching the bus stop across the workplace. Your morning shift just ended. You're not stopping for anyone nor anything else. Chantel. You purse your lips with a silent sigh as you stop. Capriana. You reluctantly turn to the high-pitched caller, slipping into receptionist mode. Hello, Capriana. You recognize her voice anywhere. Not that you can help it when she keeps calling out your name every time she passes by the counter. And you mean every single time. She looks up and out of place with her rose-tinted glasses. The breeze ruffles her bangs slightly, to which she lazily tilts her head to rearrange them. Oh no, she's beckoning you over. Your eye twitches briefly, the plaster smile still sticking on. You hear bells louder than the bicycles ringing in your head. She's the reason why you landed the job, not that you doubt your natural ability to acquire it on your own. You stroll over, your gaze shifting from the fluttering ribbon on her blouse to her face. You're not sure if you're going to focus on her eyes or the rose-tinted glasses she's infamous for wearing. You guess drama people are very iconic people. Capriana wraps the remainder of her sandwich and gestures you to take a seat. I'm not going to drag you away if that's what you're thinking. I wasn't before, but now I am. She giggles and lays back on the picnic bench. Then she fiddles with her pink gel pen. You sit beside her and she feels your puzzled look in. What I'm doing is top secret, Chantel. Do you want to hear it? There is a no option? Oh, you're so fun, Chantel. I know you want to. Come closer. You lean in, curiosity getting the better of you. Capriana whispers haughtily. A loud smack echoes in the park, making birds fly off their branches. The beetle falls to the ground and crawls away. Eh? You're no longer voicing over the scene. You can hear the mother scolding the child for dirtying his hands, catching worrisome looks from the passersby, such as yourself. The mother just smacked her child's hand and he's crying from the pain. You turn to Capriana, expecting her to stop the game, but her serious gaze is still fixed onto them, and she speaks. Mom, you... Wah! How many times must I tell you not to catch such bugs? You could have hurt yourself. She inhales. I'm sorry, let Mommy give you a hug. No, I hate you, Mommy. Mommy's sorry, next time, could you warn Mommy while standing further away? You know Mommy is afraid of bugs. Okay, sorry too, Mommy, for scaring you. The two hug and lose the unwanted attention from crowd. You can't stop, Chantel. Once the show starts, you have to continue till the end. Capriana raises her finger and shakes it at you playfully. Your mouth parts, but you have nothing to say. How do you know when the scene ends anyway? You raise both of your arms in defeat. Noted duly, Director Capriana. Why don't we do one more, but together? I promise it's more fun that way. Alright, just one more. That's the spirit. I'll let you pick. What about that kid and father again? Their party's already over. Pick your new cast. You scan across the park and your eyes land on a guy reading a book out loud beside a mailbox. You can't hear what he's saying, but you guess he's a good target. Being the guy reading his book out loud. I see him. Go ahead. Clear your throat. You're a wizard, Harry. What? Okay. Capriana giggles and the guy puts his book down to take out his water bottle. You thought of... Whoosh, I need to quench my mental and literal thirst. And you refocus on the scene with Capriana's narration. Better stay hydrated and keep my throat comfortable. I must be in top form to read the bedtime story for my brother tonight. He gulps down his drink and swiftly opens his book again, but then suddenly he puts the book down with an alarmed face. Oh no, I left the stove on at home. He stands up and shoves his book into his bag, but abruptly sits down with a blank face. Ah, oh, wait, I don't have a home, silly me. Okay, this is good. It's on your mind, but unfortunately it's not your turn. A cackle is bubbling in your chest. Ah, oh wait, I turned it off before I put on my shoes. I actually forgot my favorite drama is starting. Better get going. Uncut. Good job, Chantel. You don't realize until you tried it out that there were lots of times you could scandalize the scene. There's lots of opportunities to mock any of them, but Capriana didn't take it. You view Capriana in a new light. She's actually pretty nice and feisty. How do you know when it ends? When the happy ever after happens, you hum. Capriana continues to finish her sandwich in a single bite. As she chews it down, she addresses you. How do you find work so far? Her usual bright smile is back, and your mouth presses into a thin line. It's kind of odd that she's smiling so brightly in an instant. It's good. Thanks again for bringing me into this job, Capriana. She studies her face. The relief is evident from her tone, and somehow it seems like the smile now reaches her eyes. I'm glad to hear it. The both of you continue for a while more. Capriana even notices voices over a dog eager to eat his favorite treats that his owner brought for him. You casually ask if she has owned a dog before, to which she ruefully smiles and says that the only pet she's ever taken care of was a Tamagotchi. You bid her farewell afterwards and you retreat to your house. Okay, I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna save. And we're gonna stop here. I like that some of the narration is not... Like, that park scene showed so many other people. And we don't really see them. It's just described, and I like that part. What I would have liked in that situation is if the game let us pick who to narrate. Like if there was like three or four scenarios to narrate, and the game let us pick who it is, which one we do kind of thing. I think that would have been interesting. How do you go to... Oh, there we go. Okay, so that was Belong by A Flutter Studios. It's free right now, so if you want to check it out, it's pretty easy to get. You can get it at aflutter.h.io. So that was our second game of today's session, game number 527. So I'm going to take another break, and we'll be back with our last game. Our last game is a platformer that's set in a Spectrum emulator. Spectrum was one of the old home computers from like long time ago, 70s, I think. Well, maybe not 70s, that's a bit too long. But it's one of the older ones, and it's they still have emulators that run games from that. So this game was designed to be for a Spectrum computer. It's called Jumping Jupiter Prelude. We're gonna come back to play that in about 5 minutes or so, maybe a bit longer. I need a longer break actually, so let's say 6 or 7 minutes. And stretch, hydrate, and relax in the meantime. We'll be back shortly. Hello, I'm back. Yeah, I needed a longer break. So we are in our third game of today. This is game number 528, Jumpin' Jupiter Prelude by Quantum Sheep. You can get it at quantumsheep.h.io. Jumpin' Jupiter is a platformer of some sort, and it's for a Spectrum computer. I think it's called a ZX Spectrum. ZX Spectrum was the name of those home computers from a while ago. So this emulator, it's gonna run in the emulator for that computer. I really like the pixelated font here. It says, in the future, the last cups of tea have been scattered across the solar system. Our heroine Jupiter is on a mission to get them back at all costs. Prelude is a Manic Miner style linear platformer that starts on Mercury and ends on Earth. 15 levels in total. Huh, okay. So I'm guessing the full game, it goes all the way to Neptune? Maybe even Pluto, even though it's not considered a planet anymore? If you enjoyed the game, the normal Jumping Jupiter game continues from the space moon and goes on to Pluto. Yay, it goes on to Pluto! Another 35 levels, making a total of 50 levels of platforming action. You know, I find this interesting because they're saying there's teacups scattered everywhere. And I know there's a hypothetical thought experiment type of thing. Well, it's not an experiment, more like a concept like that examines faith and atheism, and it relates to a teacup around Saturn. So I find this funny that it's they're using teacups all over in space. Okay, keys are O, P, M, and H. It's a very odd keys. Is that spacey game for a new generation? 15 levels of platforming action, avoid enemies, collect tea, timed blocks, crumbling blocks, conveyor belts, oh my. Use keys to unlock exits, color clash, huh? No sound effects due to the limits of PGD, an irritating tune. Okay. Very special thanks to these people. And then install instructions. I think I got through all that already. All right, so let's try this out. I'll need to load up the emulator for this. I think this is the one. I think. This might be the one. No, this is not the one. There's another one. Hold on. I need to close it. How do we close this? Okay. This one, Speculator. Close this. I think it's this one. Or was it this one? Can't remember. This looks right. Yeah, okay, let's try this. How do we start? How do we start? Oh, there we go. I love the font. It's such an old style font. Jumping Jupiter, made by Quantum Sheep using PGD. By Jonathan Caldwell. Music by Quantum Sheep. OPMH. Okay. ONP. Well, ONP is, oh, there you go. And M is jump. Okay. Slightly awkward, but I think we can do it. Oh, that's time. We don't want to run out of time. Collecting teacups. Need the key to unlock those red barriers, apparently. Ah, interesting. Oh no. Can't reach that one. Oh, okay. We have to time it. Or when, like, so it's sometimes it disappears and sometimes it's there. Okay, cool. Get there quickly. Oh, no, 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 no. No, okay. Okay, here we go. Get all the teacups first. There we go. Oh. Okay. Oh, come on. No, 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 no. Oh, those are conveyor belts. Okay, okay, good to know. Come back. Come back. Okay. No. Okay. There we go. Yeah, it is. It has a very Atari feel to it. How are you doing today? Fire don't talk. Oh my god. I feel like I missed something. Okay. Got all the teacups. You good? Awesome. Yeah, I'm good. I got some good rest today. But I still have to do some more work. So I'm going to do that after the stream. Yesterday I spent all my time. Well, not all my time, but like I spent a lot of time yesterday playing Pathfinder. It was super fun. I'm at a really... Oh, wow. Jump is just not high enough. Okay. Well done. Hold on. There we go. I love the simplicity of this. Okay. So we have to go all the way back from the right side. Yeah, Pathfinder has been really fun. Because I'm past the first phase now, and now it's like you get to be a ruler, and that's really cool. You get to manage a kingdom. There's just so much stuff you can do, and so I've been playing that obsessively. Oh no, I have to get out. Okay. Ah, come on. Oh, that's a close one. Ow. Okay. No. Not good. Let's go this way again. Am I supposed to go on the right first? Might be a thing. Hmm. Wonder if I can jump on that satellite. Not the evil one, but the other one. No, I can't. Okay, cool. Okay, at least now. Okay, we don't have to stand on that, so that's good. No, don't miss that cup. That was a close one. I guess I have to jump over that somehow. Nope, that didn't work. How would we do this? Probably from the middle section. From here. No? I guess we can't reach that one. We'll have to wait until the enemy moves away and then we'd have to jump onto the lower one. There. Okay, here we go. Aphrodite's teeth. Hey, I like the trees. Oh, look! This effect is cool. Wait, why are there trees in space? Space trees. Okay, how do you, like, slip through this? Wait, what? Why are you, like... This is weird. I wonder if that's a bug. Okay. Okay. I see. Go through. Yeah, right. Okay, we got the key. No, oh. We're starting from the beginning again. Starting from the beginning is just like Atari. Yeah, those are old games. All the old games used to be like that. Oh, come on. Stop. This wasn't this hard before. Come on, this wasn't this hard. Why is it doing this now? Okay, that's better. It's useful that just touching it is enough, but it also means that touching the enemy is also enough to kill you. Oh, that was a close one. Okay. Here we go. I think we did. Oh my god. I think we did quite well this time around. Ooh, that was close. Oh no. Oh my god, no. Doesn't work. We have to wait for it to come back again. There's no way to jump past this. We have to use the platform. The key is in the corner. Oh, that was a close one. There we go. Oh, this is the one where I had to jump over the thing. I remember. There. This is the one I couldn't do before. Huh. I guess I should go through the bottom. Oops. Oh, wow. Okay. That was a bug. Okay. Why did I wait so long? Okay. I got the key. Now I need the safety to come back before I go through. Because I have a feeling I might fall. Oh no. Okay, that's not too bad actually. Here we go. Oh, we're in Earth now. That's why there's trees. It's like, why is a tree in space? Okay. What is that? What is that floaty thing? Oh. Are we in Egypt or something? Is that like a sphinx? Yeah, this is a pyramid. That's a sphinx. Okay. Oh, we're introduced to the different climates. Okay, we can't go on that. That's a bat. There we go. Okay. I need to avoid the bats. Okay, I got that. Cool. These are good designs. Only one rule I know of. Babies. Is this Rome? This is Rome. Damn it. Okay. That's gonna waste a lot of time. Ugh. Fine. Wait until that thing goes down. Oh, come on. Oh, damn it. Fine. Okay, so got the cup at the bottom, so that's good. So now we need to jump. Oh, too early. Okay, so we have to wait a bit before it goes down. Okay, now I have to go down again, and then before the horse shows up, or we could wait until the horse disappears. Time, yes. Okay. Oh, that was a close one. God damn it, you've got to be. You got to be kind. Hey, there's a... What are those? Are those toilets? Okay. I don't know what they're supposed to represent. Oh my god, this is a tight one. That's a tight one. Ooh, that was a close one. Ugh. Gonna just try to go through the bottom first and then come back from the top. Okay, here we go. Oh. Okay, we got it. We got it. Oh, we finished it. Nice. Well done, you've got all the tea. Finish this short intro. You're ready to play the main Jumping Jupiter game. Yay! We finished it. That was cool. Here we go. So that was Jumpin' Jupiter Prelude. You can get the full game at their site as well. So Quantum Sheep made this. You go to Quantum Sheep's profile, they have like a ton of games. They have a cute, very cute avatar. And see, they made a ton of these in different systems. I don't think all of these are ZX Spectrum, but a bunch of these are. So they have the full Jumping Jupiter game, which is also free. Wow. Okay, so both the prelude and the full game are, they're both free, yeah. So you can like, pay what you want, obviously. Itch.io always has that option, but yeah, you can also download it for free. Okay, so both games are available. You can do the intro if you're not sure, but you can also like get the go for the straight for the full game. It's an option too. You will need an emulator to play this. It's a ZX Spectrum emulator, but there's ton of them on the on Google. You can like find probably at least 10 or 12 of them pretty easily. You can try the various emulators to see what suits you better. So yeah, that was Jumping Jupiter. That was our last game of today's session. Okay, so we're done with our session 176. Our first game today was really, really interesting. I haven't seen a puzzle game, an open world puzzle game with such simple mechanics before. I highly recommend that for people who like Zelda-like puzzle games without the action part. It's really interesting. I loved what they did with it. And the visual novel was really cool as well, the second one. And this one is also very good. It's got that arcade difficulty from the Atari times. This is also really, that last one was also good. So we're at the end of our session for today. Today we looked at Akura by Jason Newman, Belong by A Flutter Studios, and Jumping Jupiter Prelude by Quantum Sheep. If you want to check out these games, let me just get the links for you. The art on this stream is by Rifna. You can get their the TV and the avatar is made by them, and some of my emojis. You can also check out their Redbubble, Twitter, and what's the other one? Pinterest, where they have more of their art. Rifna also streams, so it's a quick shout out to them. And also, the sound on the stream are by Shapeforms, and the music is by Andrew Sitkoff. We have, did we do a raid today? Let me think about it. Maybe? Let's see who's streaming right now. Well, here's someone I think I haven't raided in a while. So let's go raid Phabiotics. Thank you all for joining me on today's session. That was a fun one, especially all those puzzles. That was really cool. So I will be. Oh, thank you for the follow, Panic. Ave. Welcome to the Balance Alliance. Are you a streamer as well? I'm gonna give you a quick shout out. See you here. Here you go. Not sure if you are a streamer, but thank you for joining. Thank you for joining the Balance Alliance. So let's do a raid on Fey Biotics. I think they're playing something something fairly mainstream. Wait, did they stop streaming? Huh, they just disappeared from the list, so I guess they stopped. Alright, so I'm gonna raid somebody else then. Okay, let's go raid Dembai, who I haven't raided in a while. So let's do that. Thank you all for joining today. That was a super fun experience. I hope to come back on Friday with the continuation of Techno Babylon. Techno Babylon is something I've been really enjoying. It's got three playable characters. It's a point and click cyberpunk noir. One of the characters is a trans woman, so I really like that as well. It's a really cool concept and really good story so far. So I'm planning to come back with that on Friday. That's my next stream. And next week we're coming back with 6 more games from this bundle. Alright, let's go. Let's do the raid now. So Dembai is playing Prey, which is a action, like a first-person shooter, I think. So our raid message is Hearts of Light and Shadow, shift the balance in your favor. We can use any emojis with it, and let's go say hi to Dembai for when we go over there. It's also, we're also having on the internet, we're having a Plural Awareness Week or Plural Acceptance Week, something like that. And that's super fun too. So let's, any of you who are interested in knowing about that or watching some of the workshops and presentations, let me know. I will try to get you some of the information. All right, here we go. Let's go on that raid. You all have good evening, good time zone, good day. Stay hydrated, stay safe, stay balanced. We'll see you next time. Bye.